Now we are going to study about the most important point, that is most important cell organelle of the eukaryotic cell, that is nucleus. Which one? That is nucleus, which is called as master of the cell. Now in this cell here at the center the structure is present. This structure is called as nucleus. What is called as nucleus? When you studied about this nucleus, if we enlarge this, see, the eukaryotic nucleus, it consists of double layered nuclear membrane. Means this membrane is double layered nuclear membrane. Now this nuclear membrane, it is not continuous. At certain region there is presence of gaps. These gaps are called as nuclear pores. See, this is gap, it is called as nuclear pore. Okay, and such type of double nuclear membrane we can observe. The outer and inner membrane, in which there is gap between these two layers, this gap is called as nuclear space or perinuclear space. Okay, as like this, this is which one structure? This is actually nuclear membrane. This nuclear membrane. Now this nucleus, which consists of nuclear membrane, actually cell is present outside this. Okay? Here is the cell. Okay. Here is the cytoplasm. And this one is nuclear membrane. Now inside this nuclear membrane, there is presence of the cytoplasm, but this cytoplasm is of nucleus. Which cytoplasm? It is the cytoplasm of nucleus. Hence it is called as nucleoplasm. What it called as? Nucleoplasm. Or also it is called as karyolymph. What it called as? Karyolymph. Okay. Now, inside this nuclear membrane, here is the presence of another one, a spherical body. This spherical body, it is called as nucleolus. What it called as? Nucleolus. It is the nucleus of the nucleus. Nucleoplasm is the cytoplasm of the nucleus and nucleolus is the nucleus of nucleus. Okay. Now, in this nucleoplasm, there is presence of chromatin material. Which material is present? This is called as chromatin material. Now this chromatin material is actually nothing but the chromosomes. See, the chromosomes, these are the unit of hereditary. In case of human being, how many chromosomes are present? In human, there is presence of the 46 chromosomes. How many chromosomes are present? 46 chromosomes. These 46 chromosomes are actually the main character or main barrier, main unit of the hereditary. For which purpose? For the hereditary. What is meant by heredity? Heredity means it is the transmission of characters from one generation to another. Now this heredity, it is the transmission of characters
from the parents to their childs. This transmission it takes place due to these chromosomes. Hence, chromosomes are called as the barriers of the heredity. Now, this chromatin material it is observed in two form. The chromatin it is observed in two form, that is heterochromatin and euchromatin. Which one? Heterochromatin and euchromatin. Okay. Now this euchromatin and heterochromatin, these are also the chromosomal material. Only this heterochromatin, it is differentiated depending upon the staining, in which heterochromatin they show dark staining. How these are present? These are darkly stained, and euchromatin is lightly stained. Okay, this is the basic difference in euchromatin and heterochromatin. Also, heterochromatin are genetically inert and euchromatin are genetically active. Which are these genetically active? It is euchromatin. Okay, now in case of the nucleus, it consists of genetic material also, and this nucleus is all of the master of the cell, or this nucleus control activity of each and every cell. Okay, this activity of each cell organelle or total cell organelle is controlled by the nucleus. Hence it is also called as controller of the cell, means it can control all metabolic activity. Okay, now these are the major cell organelles present in case of the animal cell or in animal cell. Now along with these, there are certain structures are also present. For example, in case of the cytoskeleton is present inside the cell. Now what is this cytoskeleton? Cytoskeleton means it is the network of the structure, and this network of the structure is present to support the cytoplasm. For example, it consists of microtubules, also it consists of microfilaments. Okay, also it consists of tubulins, proteins, etc. Such type of cytoskeleton is present in the cytoplasm of cell, and it gives a perfect binding or shape to that cytoskeleton or support the cytoplasm of the cell. Okay, now in case of this cilia and flagella, these structures are also present. Which structure? Cilia and flagella. Now this cilia, it is also present in our respiratory tract. Where it is present? It is present in respiratory tract. It is also present in oviducal funnel. Where it is also present? It is present in oviducal funnel also. Okay. Now such type of cilia is present. Flagella is also present for the locomotory activity. Flagella is mostly present in case of the spur. Where it is present actually? The spur. Now along with these, in case of animal cell, centrioles are present. What is present in case of this centriole? Which structure is present? Centrioles. These centrioles are present only in animal cell. And what is its importance? This importance is they form spindle fibers during the process of cell division. This is important function, and it will be more clear in the chapter cell division, in which you will study about the two types of cell division, that is mitosis and meiosis. Okay, now this cell division, it is of two type, mitosis and meiosis. In case of this cell division, when cell division takes place, the first stage, that is this nucleus, it is called as interphase nucleus. Which nucleus? Interphase. Means it is starting nucleus, it is prepared or it is ready for the cell division. And after that, in this nucleus, whatever the changes takes place, okay, this chromatin material get changed, it becomes condensed or isolated, there is separation of the chromosomes, okay. In metaphase, now see, this, what is mean by spindle fiber, we are going to clear. When cell division takes place, first stage is interphase, then prophase, then metaphase, which one? Metaphase, after that anaphase and telophase. Okay, as like this. In case of prophase, what happened? This is cell, okay, this is nucleus. The nucleus material, it becomes dark. These are the chromosomes. In case of the metaphase, there is formation, we can appear here, that is formation of the chromosomes. Okay. In case of the third one stage, these chromosomes, these are arranged at the equator. Where these are arranged? These are arranged on the equator. It will be seen in the details of in next chapter. Here we are not going into details. Just I am trying to clear the concept of spindle fiber. What is mean by spindle fiber? Okay. Now these are the chromosomes. Okay. And these chromosomes are present at the equator. Now there is formation of such type of fibers. These fibers towards both the pole, these are called as spindle fiber. What they called as? They are called as spindle fibers. Is that clear? And from this spindle fiber, these chromosomes move towards the pole. In second, last one stage, telophase, what happened? These chromosomes, they reach at one pole. Here also there is one pole. And here is the formation of nuclear membrane and these two daughter nuclei are formed. Okay. Our point is that this spindle formation, it takes place due to the centrioles. Means centrioles are responsible for the formation of the spindle fiber on which chromosomes get moved and there is cell division takes place. And it is very important for the arrangement of the chromosome. Also it is involved in the formation of cilia and flagellates. Cilia also consist of 9 plus 2 arrangement of the microtubules, and in this cilia there will be 9 filaments are central and 9 filaments are peripheral microtubules and central are 2. Okay, these are important. In this way, in this chapter, we studied about the details of the cell organelles of eukaryotic and prokaryotic cell. First we studied about the modern theory of cell, and after that we studied about the prokaryotic cell structure. In this prokaryotic cell structure, different structures will be studied, we are studying. And then under eukaryotic cell, we studied each and every cell organelle in detail. You have to prepare this chapter, not as a chapter, it is the base of biology. The cell chapter is the basic chapter of the biology or biological science. Once you are very cleared about this cell, in this biological world, you have to clear all the concepts. The branch of biology related with the cell, it is called as cytology. Okay, so you have to study keenly or hardly about this one chapter. Now we are completed this first one chapter, that is cell, its structure and organization. Hope all of you are back home. Take care. See you soon. Thank you.